Just like in the rest of the United States, 2020 has not been overly kind to Branson, Missouri so far. Mainly I'm speaking of the tourist industry, which is what keeps Branson running. Thankfully, most of us have been kept pretty safe from the virus that has ravaged some parts of our great country. Normally, January, February, and a good part of March are pretty slow around here. Then in April, things start to pick up. This year has been different in a lot of ways. But it's kind of like my proverbial grandpa used to say. Better late than never. Memorial Day weekend, things started to hop. We actually had people in town, many with out-of-state license plates. And after everything we've been through here, it was such a glorious sight to behold. As I drove down the Branson Strip, I could not stop smiling. It was awesome to see so many cars filled with happy people having a good time. Some of the video you're watching was recorded on Monday after a lot of folks had already left town. And the reason I mention that is I want you to know on Friday and Saturday, most everywhere was jam-packed. All of the restaurants, just people were everywhere. And I'll confess that when things are that busy, I usually find something else to do. I eat at a little different hour anyway. Normally have lunch at 3 or 4 o'clock in the afternoon to avoid crowds, and it just kind of fits my schedule. But at the Grand Village, there are lots of stores to see, to shop, all kinds of fun places. So I would encourage you, when you're in Branson, be sure to check out the Grand Village and tell them Danny Branson sent you. You are bound to find something that you like and maybe even your new favorite store at the Grand Village. Also drove through Tanger Outlet Malls, and you can see a lot of cars, a lot of people shopping in the stores, people carrying bags, walking down the sidewalk, just a lot of really good things happening in Branson right now.
Hey guys, it's Dana, Big D from Big D's Barbecue. Want to invite you to come out and eat with us here at the restaurant, 1550 West State Highway 248 in Branson. Love to show you our Texas-style brisket, our Memphis-style baby backs. We have pulled pork, sausages, chickens. Every day we have an off-menu special that we do. We do smoked burgers, just a variety of fun things. Come on out and get some barbecue. We'd love to see you soon.
Restaurant that I went to over the weekend is Branson Center Stage. If you're looking for good food, good service, and live music performed every day, be sure to check out Branson Center Stage and tell them Danny Branson sent you. We are truly blessed to live in a beautiful spot of the country. Here in the Ozarks, the Branson area, we have so much just beauty around us. The hills, the valleys, the lakes, lots of things. And I hope that whenever you come to Branson, as much as we love the Strip and all of the fun things to do there, I hope you still make time to take a drive out in the country and just take in some of that beauty. That I did not record over the weekend, but it seemed really fitting to show the transformation from day to night. I love that heart on the Ferris wheel. And speaking of hearts and loving things, I love Grand Country. They have different restaurants and miniature golf, of course the live shows, just all kinds of things, but they also have Papa Grand's Pizza, and it's always fun to go. And right now they're doing things a little bit differently. They're making your plate for you, and it's really nice of them to do that. Also, they're taking some extra sanitary steps. Always a clean place, always a good place to go. Be sure to check out Papa Grand's when you're in Branson. If that guy I'm sitting with there looks familiar to you, his name is Alex. He works at the Fudge Shop at the Grand Country Complex. Be sure to stop in and say hi to him. We always have a good time together. In fact, I was all done eating pizza. I looked over at his plate, and instead of getting popcorn, I decided to get one more piece of pizza before heading over to the arcade. Naturally, sanitize my hands, follow social distancing, all of that stuff. They have all of that marked as a reminder to people. On Memorial Day, it was a rainy day, and still people in town. You can see the pictures there at the Branson Landing. A lot of people had left or were in the process of leaving, but I decided to drive down there and just kind of look around and head over to a spot that I enjoy. If I have something on my mind, I want to pray about something, I want to have some deep thinking to do, I head down by the water, and there's some benches set up, and it was kind of raining, so I just walked around a little bit, but just wanted to think about and contemplate the sacrifices that had been made on our behalf by our veterans, and just kind of wanted to think about that. Branson loves our veterans. We have the Veterans Museum. If you haven't been there, be sure to check that out. We have the Veterans Memorial Garden, just a beautiful spot. And to walk around and, again, just kind of contemplate and think and pray. All gave some gave all, so that Old Glory will always fly over the land of the free and the home of the brave. We the people raise this flag to salute you and to say thank you. While I was up there, I looked down and I saw all of the traffic whizzing by and again, just kind of in a contemplative mood. We don't know what the future holds here in Branson. We need to pray for our country and hope for the best. Right now, things are going really well. If you are healthy, we would just invite you to come to Branson. Enjoy what we have here. It is a great, great place.